Now I am healed. Now I am healed. This is the actual key to peace. We have the key to peace. We have the complete understanding. We have the practices. So we are prepared for the opposite of peace, which is to come upon this world in strong measure very soon. And it could include a constellation of situations that people simply are not prepared for. But having foresight, here we prepare ahead of time, knowing that this is to come, and are aware of the utter simplicity of peace. Now I am healed. That's all. If you understand that, that's all you need to know. Now I am healed. What does it mean? It means now, the now is here. The past, present, and future, all is one, is here. All the holiness, the holy instant is here. Another way of saying, the holy instant, I am healed. That simple. Healed of what? Our projections. All this world and everything that's happening, and even the God that people worship, is actually our projections, spiritual projections. The true God is beyond our projections, even the projection of God that we project. It's totally beyond that. We are not at the mercy of our projections. Even a projected God, a projected Savior, a projected this, projected that, those are projections, spiritual projections, projections of our imagination. We are not our projections. We are not at the mercy of our projections. Our projections are not creations. They're an attempt to create separately from God, which is impossible, from the true prime creator, which is what creates spirit and truth. That's the true prime creator, spirit and truth. So we get free of our projections by being reminded of non-projection. We're reminded by non-projection by what's called the holy instant. It's called the vision, the holy vision of oneness, the overlay, the vision of Christ. It's all the same thing. It is all when we see time. You see, truth is true throughout all time. Time doesn't change truth. So when you see truth now, you're seeing truth throughout all time. It permeates all time because time can't change it. So it doesn't matter past, present, or future. This truth is always true. Time touches it not. So the holy instant is the acceptance of our holiness. This is true. We are holy. Time doesn't change that. Space doesn't change that. Forms don't change it. Appearances don't change it. So we are aware of this. It's called the now, the true now. Now doesn't mean this present date, this present moment. It means that which is untouched by all time, past, present, and future, untouched by all space, which is truth, which is what we are, which is what we are. Lies do not change truth. Lies are what need time and space. Projection are lies, basically. It's spirit claiming it's able to create separate from God, and that's a lie. So all we do is project lies, really. And the truth of what we are remains untouched by these lies. So now I am healed. I see the right. I see the now. The truth of the holy instant, which is the now, past, present, future, permeates all time, right now, all time. All the future, all the past, right now, all the same, all the same, all the same. Totally simple, totally obvious, and when we get it, we get it. It's a key to peace of mind, actually. So it's essential to have this in place prior to the first blood moon of this tetrad that's coming up, where these changes will most likely unfold over the next year and a half in this world. And the whistleblowers are busy blowing their whistles. That's what they do. Okay, that's fine. But the whistleblowers don't have the keys to peace, don't have the key to peace. They don't know. They're just exposing this, whistleblowing this, oh, terrible this. But all they're exposing is the activity of our projections. which is always corrupt, which is always lying, deceitful, conflict, etc. It always is. Our projections are not creations, and we're frustrated by this, and so we act out this frustration through them, the conflict and the frustration. They're just acting out our own desire, spiritual desire, our whimsical desire. And when we see this, we say, oh my gosh, but what do I do with all these projections? I realize I don't really, these will never be what I want them to be, so I need to set them down. Well, instead of setting them down and getting rid of them, just allow the blessing of holiness upon all projections. So it doesn't seem like a projection anymore. See, projection takes time and space. When you realize the holy instant, which permeates all time and space right now, this instant, it permeates all of it. The permeation is not subject to time. So we call it, say it's now, but it's really timeless, a timeless permeation of all time and space with the remembrance of holiness, with the reflection of holiness. We can still function within all these projections, but we're no longer attached to any of them. We're no longer attached to the projections. It's this non-attachment, this dispassion, non-attachment. That's what brings peace. The holy instant is what brings peace. Nothing else will bring peace. All this whistleblowing and, yeah, the Pope is going to do this and this and that. And, yeah, probably. We'll see. There's just, you know. Do we know? Yes, we know. Let me see. Do we know about all this stuff? Of course we know about all this stuff, about all our projections. It's all our projections. These are all projections. So when we talk about this, the Homo capsaicins with the big head, you know, the big-headed ETs, you know, and the plots of the Vatican and all this kind of stuff. Those are just, you know, all of this is just the activity of our projections. It doesn't, to bring all this to light is fine and dandy, but it doesn't solve anything. And people just say, oh my God, you know, what can I do? And get all agitated and all fearful and all this kind of stuff. But what we're after is the holy instant, which frees us from all our projections. Frees us from, see, truth doesn't need time and space at all. It's only projections that need time and space to become true. They're not true yet. We say, well, they're not true yet, but give them enough time and space and they'll become true. So that's how they live and move and have their being within time and space. But they're not, there is no being to it, to all these projections. There's no being to it. There's no eternal life to any of it. And so it's useless in reminding us of what we are. It's completely useless. Serves no purpose whatsoever. There's not a single facet of this world that we would want to keep eternally. Not one facet of it. That should tell it all right there. So the problem is, in the next year and a half, is things are just going to, you know, people are just going to be overwhelmed by all sorts of information. And if they don't turn in the right direction, they're just going to be lost in a swamp. They're still believing in the projections. Don't believe in the spiritual projections at all. They have nothing to tell us. They will never help us. They will not be what we want them to be. And they're useless, except we can give them the sole purpose of simply being reflective, reflecting the holiness, in other words, like a mirror, so to speak. It is there to be overlaid, to be rested upon. The holiness rests upon all of it. Now we can hear this and we say, I kind of get it, but don't quite get it. Don't quite get it. And that's the boat that we're all in. We don't quite get it. But we can keep on ingesting this and getting closer and closer. We're going to need to get it coming up now, because we have to decide which way to go. We go with peace of mind, or we get involved in all the intrigues of the world. The intrigues are going off the chart. The people will get intrigued. Of course, it's easy to get intrigued if when the Pope says something, he's going to say something like, in the various financial situations that arise and the whole structure of everything that's changing very rapidly, and new world order, new world religion, new world currency, you know, how to bring peace to the planet, this, da, 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 da. All of that is much ado about nothing. There's never any such thing as peace within projection. Never. Never has been, never will be. Peace comes in being reminded of non-projection. How can the activity of our projections remind us of non-projection? They don't. They don't. They never will. But our holiness can bless us right now. Doesn't need any time or space to do that. That's why Jesus said, "As closer is the closest thing there is to us, closer than even space." It doesn't need time and space. You know, it's time, location, and time and space implies a location, whereas our holiness is not located in time and space. It's here, right now, even closer than here. It doesn't require a location or a time. So this is the direction that peace of mind can be found, and those who want peace of mind will go in that direction, and the rest will be caught up in the New World Order agenda of all the storylines, which will be, you know, interesting for sure. And people say, "Oh my gosh, I wonder what's going to happen." Remember, we're only talking about projections. All of this, people, personalities, world, belief systems, it's all projection, spiritual projection. Nothing, much ado about nothing. Much ado about nothing. So it doesn't matter what takes place within projection. It's like what takes place within a dream. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. All that matters is you awaken from the dream. That's it. You're not going to remember the dream once you awaken from it. That was a terrible nightmare. I'm going to forget that as fast as possible. So it's not really important to follow all that stuff at all. And I just went over through the internet all the various stories. I can see what's going to come out. You know, you can see what's happening. And they're trying to keep our attention glued. Our projections are trying to keep our attention glued to their activity as if it's important. It's not important. No importance to it. But boy, they're cooking up some tabloid-esque stuff for us, you know. Oh gosh. But it's already boring, right? The Pope announcing what's the Pope gonna announce? Extraterrestrials or different species here on this planet that's actually more intelligent than us, or extraterrestrials coming down, giving us a new religion and all this stuff. Maybe not, the Pope says a bit, but it doesn't matter one way or the other. We already have the keys to peace. Already have them. So why should we pay attention to what all these promises that people do, maybe this in the future, some time and space, when we already have the answer? Why chase after the answer when we already have it, is the question. Why do that? So first blood moon of the tetrad is tonight, within about the next 8 hours. And that kicks off the fun and games, the tabloid fun and games for this world. And within that, there will be a lot of stuff, probably disclosure will take place, changing of people's beliefs, rapid, you know, reassessment, everything. Much ado about nothing. Much ado about nothing. The holy instant is the answer. The holy instant is the answer. Now. The now. Seeing the now. That's not mindfulness, you know, it's not mindfulness meditation, like I'm aware of that leaf, I'm aware of this thing, and I'm just living in the now of what's happening at this present. No, that's not it at all. The now, it refers to our holiness. That it encompasses all time. It refers to our holiness. It's not referring to that bird chirping or something like that. or we notice the movement of nature. No, it refers to our holiness. That all of these movements and activity and appearances don't change our holiness in the slightest bit. And that time is totally irrelevant to our holiness. But wherever we are within time and space, everything that we're aware of certainly reflects our holiness back to us, effortlessly. So we have to refine this and refine this, refine this, refine this, refine this. And it's going in and out of clarity for me, in and out, you know, just, it's hard to explain it, but you can feel it. It's so simple and so obvious, so simple and so obvious. Probably just waiting to see what our projections are going to do, because we still have interest in what we think are our creation. You know, all this is we think is our creation. So of course we're very interested in it. You know, what's the Pope going to do, really? Is going to say the extraterrestrials exist or not? You know, that kind of thing. Is it going to collapse the financial system? Illuminati, are they going to plan? Are they going to succeed? Is there going to be World War III or not? And all this kind of stuff. We're still interested in all that to a certain extent. But really, there's no point to it. There's no point to it. It doesn't get us anywhere. It doesn't get us anywhere. We end up, we die, we realize we didn't get anywhere. We just got fooled by our projections again. Just fooled by them. We're just deceiving ourselves. It's called self-deception. Self-deception. Our holiness is untouched by our projections, entirely untouched. Another way of putting it, there's no place within time and space where our holiness is not perfect. As long as we think we're in hope, as long as we have our attention on time and space, we see it as there's no place where our holiness is not perfect. Holiness does not need time and space to be what it is. Perfect. Perfect without the option of not being perfect. Now I am healed. By seeing the now, seeing this now, which is the holy instant, the instant, seeing that my holiness doesn't require time. To be what it is. And that all time, it's still what it is. Throughout all time, infinity of time, still it is exactly what it is. Seeing that, we are healed. I am healed. In other words, I'm remembering non-projection. Healing is the remembrance of non-projection. So say, Holy Spirit, let the light of now, the holy light of now, shine upon my perception. Let the holy light of now shine upon my perception. Or let my holiness shine upon my perception. Let the light of my holiness shine upon all perception right now. There are various ways you can say it. I've been working with this today, but it's very simple. We don't have to wander off into complexity. Conspiracies, disinformation agents, who's paying who. There's no need to wander off into any of that. May the light of my holiness shine upon my perception. This very moment. May the light of my holiness shine upon my perception. This is awareness of the holy instant. May the light of my holiness shine upon my perception. A simple prayer, simple affirmation, simple acceptance. May the light of holiness shine upon my perception. May the light of that which doesn't need any projection, no time and space for it to be what it is, shine upon my perception. Shine upon my perception. And thus, my perception reminds me of non-projection. It's alarmingly simple, actually, alarmingly simple. And that's the trouble we have. Say, oh gosh, it's too simple. I don't like that. Let's make it more complex. And then you get all these layers of complexity, which aren't necessary. If you have to look at complexity and realize it's an expression of fear, it's an expression of fear from the continuity fear that we have, saying, oh my gosh, I don't want it too simple, because then I might experience the holy instant. I'm scared. So let's make it real complex. And then we think the complexity is the key secret to the teachings. It's not. It's an overlay of fear. It's an expression of the fear of simplicity. May my holiness shine upon my perception. May the shining truth of my holiness rest upon my perception. May the shining truth of my holiness rest upon my perception. May the shining and unalterable, time-free, space-free, shining of my holiness rest upon my perception. May my holiness, which needs no time and no space to shine the truth of what it is, rest upon my perception. We just look at this simple, simple, simple fact of how we're healed. Now I am healed. That is like the simplest, one of the simplest versions, just now. Ah, now. Look about it. Oh, this is now. I'm seeing the now. The now is the shining of our holiness upon our perception. That is what's called the now. I'm seeing the now. Now, then you realize, I'm healed. That's what heals me. The now heals me. The now, past, present, future, all space. All space, all time. Not needed for holiness to be what it is. That shines upon all time and space. So now I am healed. I see my holiness, past, present, future. Fill all space, past, present, future. It seems to overflow it all. You might say it's a vision of this overflowingness, that time and space cannot contain it. There's another way of looking at it. Overflowing bliss, I see overflowing bliss, I am healed. By seeing overflowing bliss, I am healed. I'm reminded of non-projection. Projection cannot contain it. It overflows it. So everything you see has this quality, it seems, where it's not containing. Another way, self-released. Longjima calls it self-released. Everything seems to be self-released. Everything you perceive as being self-released, it cannot contain itself. All projections can't contain themselves. This leaf, this plant, is so this plant cannot contain itself as a plant. Nothing you see can contain itself in time and space as an actual appearance. It seems to be self-released from its appearance. into eternal wholeness and eternal holiness. So everything you see seems to be self-released into holiness. Even the form of time and space itself. And it's always self-released. It's always self-released into holiness. You could say, for all time. It's always going to be this way. So this, the self-releasedness of this plan will always be that way in time and space. Time and space cannot contain it. So people can say, well, I see the holiness of this table. I see the self-releasedness of the table. I see the holy instant of this table. I see everything as right now, as it is, self-released into the holiness, into the wholeness. And that is the beauty. That is the bliss, is that the wholeness is not conditioned by appearance. All appearance intrinsically is self-released as holiness. It cannot be contained. Appearance cannot contain holiness, what it is. It is not mere appearance. But we're just looking at this here. Making efforts to kind of get familiar with it. And that's all that's really needed on the path. That's all that's really needed is look at this central issue. Now I am healed. Now I am healed. This came direct from the Holy Spirit. I asked this morning, okay, Holy Spirit, one last teaching before the first blood moon, and which kicks off this April 15th, the time of action in the world. What would you have me say to you? And it came very, very clearly. Now I am sick. I am healed. Now I am healed. And I said, yeah, now I am healed. So when you see everything, all forms, as not being able to contain themselves as form, but as overflowing into this one seamless holiness that is not an appearance, a particular localized appearance at all. Everything that you see is self-released into this holiness. Then you're just having a vision of holiness. Okay, the vision of oneness, a holy vision of oneness. Because everything is self-released into this oneness. No appearances are able to constrain themselves as an appearance. This is what the mystics have always talked about, is vision of oneness. Everything appears to be holy. St. Patrick talked about it. Just, I see God everywhere. Nothing I look at isn't God. I see, isn't this holy oneness? In other words, appearances cannot hide the holiness. Our projections no longer hide our holiness. Projections are designed, really what they do is they make us blind to our holiness. But we've decided, I will no longer be blind to my holiness. And therefore I accept this vision of holiness. I accept the healing of my perception. I accept the healing of my perception. It's a choice we make. It's God's deal with us that we can still see form. But see, all form is not being able to truly define itself as a form. The form now becomes the shadow of what it really is. All appearances then are just shadows of what the truth of what is, which is really, it's just representing holiness. See, that's the way you turn it around and get free and have projections remind you of non-projection. So, one other issue here is, this is like crossing the finish line, getting the keys to peace, accepting the keys to peace, knowing we have the keys to peace. It's crossing the finish line. We need to be aware of this. But getting to the finish line, it's what's important is crossing it. Now, we may collapse across it. We may be dragged across it. We may crawl across it, roll across it. We may be staggered across it. But that's okay. It doesn't matter how you cross it. It only matters that you get there. And so for me, I'm barely making it. It's like if you, in old times, let's say the knights went away to a battle, great battles, great campaign, maybe went on 15 years, a great elite war, and they came home at the end of the war, back to their city, their town, their village, whatever. And the knights that campaigned, you know, they come back and they're injured, they're limping. They're tattered. They're tired. You can see the scars of war all over them, you know, and they come back exhausted. And the people say, you know, they really gave it everything. They really gave it everything. Whereas if the knight comes back and they're prancing on their steed and all fresh as a daisy, and you say, hey, wait, I mean, what did you do? What did you do? You probably didn't do anything. So. It's honorable to stagger across the finish line because it means you're really engaged in this effort. So for me, I'm like collapsing across the finish line here, really collapsing. My body is just collapsing. It's almost like becoming hardly functional at times. It's just amazing how it's freezing up on me. I can hardly raise my arms. Just this massive, you know, you feel just the huge stress and strain of it's battling for so many, many, many years against all this misdirection of our projections and trying to get to the focus on, you know, what's really helpful to us. It's just an incredible battle. And it's showing up now suddenly all my whole body is becoming like arthritic. And just like woke up one morning, what wasn't there in that before, and suddenly this, you know, woke up one morning, it's just like, wow, just feel this. You know, like freezing up, staggering across the finish line because it reflects the fear that is to come in the world. The how the world will be paralyzed by all this activity of its projections. How we spirit will become mesmerized by everything. And we don't want to be mesmerized by it whatsoever. I'm so tired of all that stuff. Very tiresome. I want peace of mind. So. Don't be worried if you're exhausted right now. Should be. If you've been given everything you got, you stagger across the finish line, you don't have anything left in the tank. Gas tank, you spent it all. That's what I did, I spent it all. And still am, you know, barely functional, actually, at this point. But that's okay. That's okay, because I know now I am healed. If form cannot hold, then where does it matter that form arises in time and space? Does it really matter in the slightest bit? If you become aware that appearance cannot define holiness, mere appearance cannot define holiness at all. It cannot be contained. Oneness cannot be contained within fragments. Once that's realized, then it doesn't matter. You see, that's a realization that's good for all time and all space, all appearances. Once that realization comes, that clears all appearances. Finished. Healed. You're not concerned about any appearance anymore. That's why there's some techniques just to focus just on one object and to see the holiness as it self-releases into the holiness that is truth and not mere appearance. Then that can generalize to all objects everywhere. So this is a technique that's been used in the past. All sorts of different techniques have been used in the past and will be used in the future, and you know, it goes on and on. So we don't need to panic, we don't need to freeze up, we don't need to get consumed by concern. We have the key to peace. We have the key to peace. The key to peace has been made very simple, very clear. And we simply need to practice it, practice and practice until piece of cake for us, piece of cake. Okay, we'll see what the next taping will be like. All right, very great. That's it for this one.